Later this year, the world's population will cross the 8 billion mark. That's a big milestone, so it seems like a proper time to consider our place in history. In this video, we'll look at three questions. First, how big is 8 billion compared to the total number of people who have ever lived? Second, how many people will exist in the future? And third, is there anything we can do to positively affect that future? 8 billion is a big number. If you spent 1 minute meeting each of these people, doing it 16 hours per day, not including breaks to eat or go to the bathroom, you'd need to live over 22,800 years to get to everyone. And by then, of course, there would be quite a few new people for you to meet. Even just at this moment, there is far more humanity than any of us can even begin to know. What about people who lived in the past? It's not possible to get a precisely accurate number here, but we can refer to the work of historians and demographers to get a rough idea. The source I'm using for this is by Toshiko Kaneda and Carl Haub from 2021. According to their sources, including those alive today, nearly 117 billion people have ever lived. That's a little over 14.5 current Earth populations, and flipping that number around, people alive today represent about 6.8% of all people so far. Okay, what about the future? Counting past people is hard, but counting future people is even harder. We just don't know what's going to happen. As always, with the big question, a good way to start is to break it down into smaller questions. All the years of the future will come one at a time, so one question is, how many people will be born each year in the future? This is kind of many questions, one per year, but we might be able to find a mathematical function to describe the overall pattern. And people will keep being born until humanity eventually goes extinct. So a second question is, how long will humanity last? To track how we're breaking things down, it'll be useful to show what this idea looks like when written as an equation. We're gonna add up the people born next year, and the people born the year after that, and so on, all the way until the final year humans exist. And to fit every future year on the screen at once, we can use this sum notation. This makes the math start to look a little bit scary, but it just means add up the new births each year from next year until the final year. Okay, so now we can tackle these questions one at a time. The usual situation in biology, if the environment is steady, is that a successful organism's population grows exponentially until it reaches the carrying capacity of its niche. From there, the population fluctuates up and down with members competing for limited space and resources. For us, the niche would be whatever we can squeeze out of the space and natural resources of Earth. And once we reach that limit, just like for other organisms, the competition would not be pretty. Even if technology improves to let us support more life per resource, that would just increase the limit, not get rid of it. This is known as the Malthusian Trap. It's a grim picture. So grim, someone might wish they could just snap their fingers and cut the population in half to avoid all that ugliness. But fortunately for us, we don't seem to be headed in that direction. As countries improve in life expectancy, education, and income, their birth rates tend to drop close to 2 children per woman, keeping the population steady rather than growing it. So as the world continues to develop in these ways, it seems likely that the pattern of stable populations will become widespread, and our population will be steady with no war, famine, or supervillains necessary. The United Nations projects that this effect will cause the world population to peak at about 10.4 billion people around the end of this century. The UN also estimates that the global average lifespan at the end of the century will rise to about 82 years. Some people will live longer than that, and some people will die earlier than that, but on average, every 82 years, the population will replace itself. So 10.4 billion people will be born every 82 years, getting us to an average birth rate of 127 million people per year. This number will almost certainly be at least a little bit wrong. For example, while I was working on this video, a new UN report came out and I had to update my numbers. But the main idea here is that it's reasonable to model our population as being roughly constant as long as we're on Earth. The true birth rate will fluctuate, but over long time spans, it'll average out to some number rather than growing in some wild way. The best current estimate seems to be about 127 million people per year starting in 2100, and we can update that number as we learn more in the future. And now that we've decided to model the birth rate as a constant number of people per year, on average, we can get rid of this summation sign and just multiply the birth rate by the number of years to get the total number of people born in the future. So the remaining question is, how many years are there in humanity's future? There's a huge range of possibilities here, so we'll look at a few different cases going from pessimistic to optimistic. The first case is one where we somehow kill ourselves in the relatively near future. This makes the number of years in the future approximately zero, and so we're done. The next case is more neutral, where we don't do anything too crazy and we last about as long as a typical mammalian species. There's a range of estimates for how long a mammalian species typically lasts. 1 million is a round number in that range, so let's use that. With about 200,000 years already behind us, this leaves about 800,000 years to go, leading us to a total of 101 trillion future people. That's 12,625 times Earth's current population, and with that total, the 117 billion people so far only account for about 0.1% of all people who will ever live. The next case is one where we survive as long as the Earth is able to support us. The Sun has about 5 billion years left before it runs out of hydrogen in its core. After that, it'll transform into a red giant and envelop the Earth. But before that happens, the Sun will increase in brightness. Astronomers estimate that in about 1 billion years, the Sun will be bright enough to boil the oceans. Maybe we could manage that somehow, but it seems fair enough to assume that's the end of life on Earth. 127 million births per year for 1 billion years leads to 127 quadrillion future people. I really don't think it's possible to actually grasp how big that number is, let alone the fact that each one of them is potentially a human life, but it can be fun to try. 127 quadrillion is almost 16 million times Earth's current population. All these globes from the last case were already as much as my computer could handle, so you're just gonna have to imagine 1,200 of these containers at once. Another way to think about it, if this many people eventually exist, the 117 billion people so far represent only about a millionth of all the people who will ever live. Anyway, that's not even the limit. We have the potential to outlast the Earth itself. Based on our understanding of physics, it should be very doable to figure out how to live further away from the Sun as it gets brighter, on Mars or the moons of Jupiter, or even in structures we create and put into orbit ourselves. Those are tough engineering problems for sure. But we have literally a billion years to figure it out, and the basic physics we need is already understood. The possibilities get pretty wild once we assume humans have left Earth, and especially if we leave the solar system. So we won't try to come up with any numbers here, at least in this video, but you can imagine the numbers would get pretty bonkers. So we have this huge range of possibilities, from a very short future all the way to a potential future that makes 100 quadrillion people seem small. It's hard to know what to make of this. The takeaway I find striking, though, is that as long as we don't mess things up ourselves, we're very early in the history of humanity, and others will look back on us as an ancient civilization. So, is there anything we can do to help these future people out? It's not a simple question, and there's certainly a lot we can't control from the present. But given how many people could potentially benefit, it seems very worth trying to figure out how to do our best. There are two broad categories for how we can positively affect the future. The first, as we've already mentioned, is just not messing things up and cutting our future short. You might hear people talk about this category as existential risks. The second is how we can put humanity on a good trajectory so those future lives are more likely to be good lives. I hope to make videos about both of these categories over time. And a major source for those videos will be a new book called What We Owe the Future by Will MacAskill, which is out now. The ideas in it are super important and just plain interesting. If you'd like to pick up a copy, you can find a link in the description. I really can't recommend it enough. And as always, thanks for watching.